Morning friends, I am Neha and I welcome you all in the Morning Tale series of our current affairs. A very very happy Independence Day as well as Raksha Bandhan Day to all of you. And a special announcement for today is that we have provided a discount of 25% especially on the occasion of Independence Day. You can avail the discount on all of our courses up to a 25% by writing the word independence in capital letters in the special coupon code block. Make it a hurry and avail the special discount of 25% on all of our courses. And now let us begin our morning tales for 15 August 2019. So the first question is, who heads the delimitation committee of India? So there are various questions that we are going to discuss in this single question only. So the first question which arises here is that what is delimitation committee? The delimitation committee was set up in the year 2002 by an act of parliament, which is Delimitation Act 2002. So this delimitation committee has been set up under the Delimitation Act 2002. And now what is the main purpose of this commission? So the commission has been tasked with the work to redraw the boundaries of various assemblies and Lok Sabha constituencies based on their recent census. So basically, as we all know that recently Jammu and Kashmir Reorganization Bill has been passed, which mandates to create two new union territories. So in this regard, this delimitation committee has initiated the work of redrawing the assembly seats or basically the Lok Sabha constituencies in the newly created union territories. Now let us discuss something about the seat matrix of Jammu and Kashmir. So the one thing of utmost importance is that the number of seats has been increased from the erstwhile 107 to 1114. So now Jammu and Kashmir constituency has 114 seats a total of. And out of these 114 seats, 24 seats have been kept aside for the areas of POK, that is Pakistan Occupied Kashmir. And this means that elections will be conducted only for the 90 seats. Basically, 24 seats have been designated for the Pakistan Occupied Kashmir. And these 90 seats will be contested by the contenders. So this was the most important part, that the seats in these new union territories have been increased from 107 to 1114. And the second most important information to be discussed here is that this delimitation process of J&K as well as Ladakh will be based on the recently conducted census, which is the census 2011. So the delimitation process will be based on the census 2011. Do remember this thing. And now let's come back to the answer to this question, which is option A, Justice Kuldeep Singh. So he is the chairman of this delimitation commission. Now let's discuss the second question of today, that is, which state has launched the E-Step initiative to empower students' startups? So quite intriguing and interesting initiative it is that has been taken up by a state government. So the question asks you that which state government has launched this initiative. So the answer is option D, Karnataka. Karnataka has recently launched this E-Step initiative under its already ongoing Karnataka Innovation and Technology Society. So this is the society under which this E-Step initiative has been initiated. Now, under this initiative, the students, startups, as well as entrepreneurs will be trained about the basics of entrepreneurship. And obviously, this step has been taken in order to promote the entrepreneurship skills in students as well as new entrepreneurs. So this is all about this question. And now let's move on to the third question of today. Friends, this is quite an important question, so do listen to this question very carefully. Recently, India and Russia have committed to increase their bilateral trade to dash by 2025. So recently, India-Russia cooperation in the Russian Far East Forum has been concluded, and it has been concluded in Russia. So this is another information out of which a question can be framed, that where was this India-Russia cooperation in the Russian Far East Forum held? So it was held in Russia. And in this forum, India and Russia have committed to increase their bilateral trade up to 30 billion. So the answer to this question is option E, that is $30 billion, which is the target set by India and Russia to increase their bilateral trade by 2025. Now this number becomes very important in terms of the present bilateral trade. Basically, when we compare this number with the present bilateral trade between India and Russia. So according to the data, the bilateral trade in the year 2018-19 between India and Russia stands at 8.3 billion. This is in USD, basically US dollar. So this is the amount of trade conducted between India and Russia in the year 2018-19, and now both the countries have set the target to upscale it to 30 billion. Now, apart from this target, India and Russia have also signed various MOUs in this forum. So what are those MOUs? MOUs have been signed between India and Russia for cooperation in various fields such as trade, economy, investment, science and technology. Apart from this, a very interesting MOU has been signed between MIT University and Far East Federal University of Russia to enhance the cooperation between these two universities in the field of education and research. So that was one interesting MOU. Another interesting MOU has been signed between National Skill Development Corporation and Far East Investment and Export Agency in order to develop the skills of the youth and workforce of Russia and India. So do remember these three points about this forum, that point one is the bilateral trade. The target is 30 billion. Point two is the MOU signed between MIT University as well as Far East Federal University. And number three, the MOU signed between National Skill Development Corporation and Far East Investment and Export Agency. Apart from this, an agreement was also signed between Russia and India to establish Center for Yoga representative offices as well as Pushkin Center for Russian Language and Cultural Studies. This is not so important when compared to the other developments that had taken place in this forum. And now let's begin our next question. This is another quite important question, that is, who has been appointed as the judge of the non-resident panel of Supreme Court of Fiji? Now, why is this question so important? This is because the person who has been appointed as the judge in this non-resident panel of Supreme Court of Fiji is the first Indian to be appointed as a judge in a Supreme Court of another country. So basically, he, that is Justice Madan Lokur, is the first person in India to be appointed as a judge in a Supreme Court of another country. And that country is Fiji. So do remember these two points about this question, because the other way around that the question can be asked is that who is the first Indian to be appointed in the Supreme Court of another country or to be appointed in the Supreme Court of Fiji. And now let's move on to the next question of today, that is, who has become the first Indian chef to be awarded with the Order of Agriculture Merit Honor by France? Quite important from exam point of view. So recently, France government has honored this person with the Order of Agriculture Merit, and this person has become the first Indian chef to be honored with this great award. So the name of this person is Priyam Chatterjee. That is option D. So Priyam Chatterjee has been given this award for his marvelous performance in promoting gastronomy. So now the question must be coming in your mind is that what is gastronomy? So gastronomy refers to the study of relationship between food and culture. Basically, if we take the example of Europe and India, so you can easily locate the differences in the food as well as in the culture. And this difference in food habits is due to the culture. So that is the relationship between food and culture, which is studied in this gastronomy. So that is the quite superficial or basically the quite surface level definition of gastronomy. But that is enough for the examination point of view. So you need not to worry yourself about the details of gastronomy. And now let's move on to the next question. That is, which state? This is state, not states. And it has been written as states due to some technical error. So I would suggest you to ignore it and focus on the content. So which state has won the Best Innovation and Initiative Leadership Award at the 14th World Education Summit held in New Delhi? So important from exam point of view? Yes. So recently, the state of Rajasthan has been awarded with the Best Innovation and Initiative Leadership Award for its achievements in higher education at the 14th World Education Summit. So this is a factual question, but might be asked in the examination. Now, the other state, that is Bihar School Examination Board, has also been awarded, and Bihar School Examination Board has been awarded in the category of government's initiative to promote and develop the technologies. So this is the category in which Bihar School Examination Board has been awarded. Bihar School State Board has done a tremendous as well as a good job in promoting the technology in conduction of examination. So that is why Bihar has been awarded. Now the other thing that needs to be discussed here is about the summit. So this is the 14th edition of World Education Summit, and this summit focuses on the academic sector. So that was all about this question, but do remember this thing, that this summit was held in New Delhi. Moving further with the next question, that is, which sport has been recently included in the 2022 Birmingham Commonwealth Games? The Commonwealth Games has included three new sports in its 2022 edition, and these three sports are: first is T20I women's cricket, second is beach volleyball, and the third one is para table tennis games. So these are the three games which have been included in this 2022 edition of Commonwealth Games, which is going to take place in Birmingham. Now, where is this Birmingham? You have to tell me in the comment section below that where is this city located. Apart from this, there is another news surrounding the Birmingham Commonwealth Games, that is, India has proposed or basically has threatened to boycott these games if the shooting sport is not included in the 2022 Commonwealth Games. So that was the news surrounding Birmingham Games. And now let's move on to the next question, which is a static question. So who is the president of International Olympic Committee? Some days back, Anuj sir has himself discussed about the headquarters of International Olympic Committee. So I would like you to answer the headquarters of International Olympic Committee in the comment section below, so that I also get the idea that you are following the current affairs on a daily basis. So the answer to this question is option A, Thomas Bach, who is the president of International Olympic Committee. And do not forget to mention the headquarters of International Olympic Committee in the comment section below. Question number 9 for today is, who is the Secretary General of Amnesty International? So Amnesty International is a humanitarian organization, and the Secretary General of Amnesty International is option C, Kumi Naidu. We have also discussed the headquarters of Amnesty International in one of our morning tales earlier. So do you remember the headquarters of Amnesty International? If you do, then mention it in the comment section below. And now the last question for today is, who is the chairman of SEBI? So out of these five options, it is option E, Ajay Tyagi, who is the chairman of SEBI. Thank you so much guys for watching our video, and now it's time to conclude the morning tales for today. And friends, if you have liked our video, so do not forget to subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for all the latest notifications. Thank you so much.